Thanks, Clinton. The heat and its impact on livestock is our top story in the Beef Today report. Drover's Cattle Network is reporting between 1,000 and 1,500 head of cattle have died from the excessive heat and humidity in the state of South Dakota. The state veterinarian says his office is still compiling the numbers. Reporting is not mandatory, and many producers may not check in with the state officials. A big problem for cattle is that there's been no reprieve in the evenings when the nighttime low temperatures remain above 70 degrees. Cattle cannot shed the body heat that they build up during the day. Meanwhile, in the nation's top cattle state, producers are culling deeper into their herds because of the lack of grazing, dwindling hay supplies, and shrinking surface water. The Texas AgriLife Extension says livestock producers are selling larger heifers and 3- to 6-year-old cows that should form the core of future production. Producers are also selling calves early. At some auction barns, the cattle count is twice the number than normal. The extension says in some cases, auction markets are turning away producers because of the high volume of animals. In a related note, the Cattle on Feed report comes out on Friday. Our reporting partners at Beef Today say some analysts are predicting lower cattle placements, and that would be contrary to what we're hearing about drought forcing cattle to market. Beef Today says some stocker cattle may be going into smaller yards that are not part of USDA's Cattle on Feed survey. Our analysts say those animals are still out there and will move to larger yards and slaughter eventually. On to other news now. The tick-borne disease anaplasmosis can take a toll on cattle, according to University of Florida livestock specialists. As many as 50% of adult cattle over the age of 3 will die from the disease if left untreated. Treating this bacterial infection can cost farmers as much as $400 per animal, a cost that is passed on to consumers at the store. But new research at the University of Florida could help find a vaccine for the bacteria. UF scientists have mapped out the genetics of multiple strains of the bacteria. By finding out what the different strains have in common, researchers have clues to find a vaccine to fight the illness.
And hopefully it will help lead us to developing a better vaccine system, because there have been a couple of vaccine systems in anaplasma that have been proposed before, and none of them are perfect. So we keep working towards getting a better vaccine system, and hopefully one of these days we can develop a vaccine that will be safe and effective.
Dr. Dark says there are about 20 known anaplasma bacteria that make cattle sick. Also, their research could also help find human diseases. He says the pathogens are similar to human pathogens. By studying the animal models, they could create breakthroughs in human diseases. You can get many more updates on the beef industry, including market and production information, from our partners at beeftoday.com.